Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at ubnradio.com.
Well, her name is Heidi Selexa. The world revolves around her smile.
I bought a super pretty pink bikini this weekend to match my super pretty pink lipstick.
Oh, but being in a new relationship is so fun. Like, talking to him on the phone and you talk for hours, and then finally, like, somebody has to get off the phone, so you're like, bye. No, you hang up. you hang up first. Hello? So then you have to call him back a fifth time, and then the sixth time, and so then the seventh time, you just can't stop hitting redial. And then you break up.
Let's see if I can pick up a gay guy. How are you?
Good, how are you doing?
Good. You're cute. You're welcome. Do you want to be my friend?
You're obviously committed and somebody's a little jealous of somebody.
Did you see that? Like, I can't believe you didn't just say, yeah, why don't you just come here?
Because they have another token gay girl.
Hi, God, it's me again. I tried to call you earlier, but you didn't answer your phone. I went right to the voicemail.
She's got the giggle. She's got the wiggle.
Hi, so sorry. So I just want you to know, I was not being mean earlier, but I had ordered my wine. And, you know, when I order the wine in the daytime, usually that means I'm going somewhere because I don't just stay at home and drink in the day. So I just wanted to let you know that.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Because he said he was going to be there in 20 minutes, and it just totally threw me off. I actually came to my show half naked. I forgot to put a top on, so I'm in lingerie right now. You can't, you know, I mean, it totally threw me off. So, you know, when Heidi wants her wine, what do?
When he wants the wine, well.
I'm sorry, what?
No, you said, if you want a lime?
No, I said, when Heidi wants her wine.
Oh.
Unless you can get buzzed off a lime.
Okay. Yeah. We'll try our best to make sure you get your wine.
Okay. Well, thank you. What's your name? You sound like you're from the South.
Oh.
Okay. Okay. Well, great. Thank you so much, cutie. Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Did I just call him cutie? Oh, my gosh. Okay. I'm like, hi. Oh, wait. I have a present for you guys. Wait. Where's my balls? Oh my God, I left him at home. And they caused me to lose my balls. Don't ever leave your balls at home. Okay? Because without balls, well, you may have a backbone, but it's not rolling. Did that make any sense? Anyway, I'm Heidi Selexa, and welcome to Out of the Friend Zone. I have got the most amazing chick singer. Woo! Bring her on. All right, you sing it, sister. Lakotah.
Hello.
Yeah, it's L-A-K-O-T-A-H, and you have to say the T. Wait, Lakotah. Because last night I said Lakotah, and she goes, by the way,
I think you're great. No, God. Heidi, but it's a T.
Yeah.
And she's done very well so far.
Oh, the tea has?
Yes. You've done quite well.
Oh, well, I've been practicing all night with
have
the
you?
Teas. The Tom. Ugh, don't like the word Tom. Those are all my exes. Anyway, back to you. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
It's a pleasure. It's super exciting.
So I have to tell you, I was listening to your music, and I was in the mirror, which I am half the time when I'm home. I decided instead of, you know, just putting three mirrors in my place, I would put them all around. So in my moments of vanity or, you know, the occasional boyfriend that comes over in his moment of, you know, vanity, he can just look at himself right where he's at. Either way, he knows there's a mirror anywhere from either angle, okay? So it just makes things a lot easier, you know?
Of course.
It's much better than photos, and it looks like you have a mansion.
Ah, but mansion.
When I was sitting there last night in all my mirrors, I put your music on again, and I listen to things at different times of the day. When I'm listening to somebody's album, and your producer's great, but he called me during it. I said, I told you I would text you when I was done listening. I do not like to be interrupted when I'm listening to somebody's album. When you're listening to somebody's album, you need to have a moment to, you know, absorb the album. That could be for anything that you're absorbing. But on that note, I'm sitting in the mirror, and I was sitting there, and I was like, oh, God, this is sexy music. And I started putting way more red lipstick on than normal. I was putting powder on my face, you know, 8 o'clock after my run. Let me powder my nose. I felt like I was the sexiest woman in the world. So your music is very sexy.
Yes, and that's its purpose.
Is to be sexy.
It's to be sexy for all who listen.
Right?
Om yum no yum.
Ooh, do you meditate? you need to put that in there.
I do.
Because I didn't hear that in
no,
there.
No mantras in there, no.
No, but you need to do that.
It's not a bad idea, you know, but it is, it seems to be come from that chakra. From what I'm
the
getting.
Vocal chakra, no, or the root.
The sexual chakra.
Oh, that's the second chakra.
The album. Oh,
that's the sacral chakra. It's
that
orange.
The sacral chakra.
It's the second one.
The second,
it's
second
right there,
one.
Right above the pelvis area. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. There's a second chakra in there, and it's usually an orange color. Sometimes when you close your eyes, if you notice, you will see colors. And that's the chakra.
Oh,
because
wow.
We're way more smart than we think we are, intuitively, right?
Absolutely. But,
and I felt very intelligent when I listened to your music.
Yes.
Because I felt a connection with the way your intelligence works, the way that you process. My engineer, well, are you taking my purse away? Well, okay, I only have the red lipstick out of there. There's no gloss over here. Just kidding.
Wish I had a red lipstick.
I just love to tell him what to do. It's like, you know, leave your balls at home. I mean, don't leave your balls at home.
No. Take them with you, sweetie.
So because when I heard your voice, on your album a week ago, and I went, yummy. The word that came to my mind was yummy.
Sweet.
Okay, now I used to call the boyfriend that I dated across the hall, which was much younger than me, I just call him yummy. So when it came to my mind, I felt I wish yummy was here. It was yummy to me.
That
you
makes
know,
sense.
Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
And so, you know, I was thinking as a young child, did she walk around her house singing, you know, in church or not that, you know, or I mean, how did you figure out you could sing?
Well,
did you just start belting out one day and in your meditation?
No. My father is a singer. Mm-hmm. And when I was very small with my sisters, we started performing with my father. So I've sang since I was just a little girl.
Aww.
And harmonies with my father. And he was an actual country singer.
Oh.
And he would sing. He didn't break through the big time as I'm doing.
Yeah.
But he played around a lot. And it was really great because I learned the backbone of music as a child. So I've been singing since I was a little girl. And
is that when you were in London? Or
No, I was born in actually New York.
I just thought I would add that because she did the London accent.
Well, I can't. It comes in and out, you know. But my mother's from there, so I was there.
Oh,
yes,
so you hear it all the time.
You know,
you're half your dad, half your mom.
Yes,
depending on what words you say,
what mood, you know, what party.
Right. Sometimes when I'm real tired, I'll walk around like I'm from the South, and I'll say, "Now, sweetie,
you know, ain't that something?" Because I was doing that just a while ago,
and it really kind of helps you understand the thought process that goes on in somebody's mind when they are tired.
Right. Lord knows you are so correct.
The Lord does bless me.
Bless you.
I'll tell you.
So you do that too?
I do.
Wow.
Like randomly. I don't
Dude.
Know. People have left my house Jeez. When I did it too many. They're like, okay, that's enough. We're not in this. And then I'm like, oh, Mama, I really love him, Mama. And they're like, okay, where's Heidi? Bring back Heidi. And I'm like,
Mama.
And then she's like, I knew I shouldn't have married her father.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. But like I practice all these. And then everyone's like, okay, I like Heidi, you know. Like they're not even connecting with me when you're
Don't
that.
Listen to them. You have to be all those of who you are.
Right, but when you're tired, my gosh, you know. I mean, men don't understand that sometimes when women are tired, that we don't want to, you know, do things to them that we normally would do if we had energy.
Word.
They think that because they were born.
Entitlement,
right?
I believe.
Yeah.
Entitlement,
right?
Sexual entitlement.
It is. It's because they're bigger than we are.
And in my country, we don't have that for my people.
Oh. Well,
so I tell you now, Heidi.
Isn't that something? They don't have the same thing over there that we have over here.
No, they don't.
They don't. Well, I apologize. I thought you knew what was going on down here.
I knew what's going on down here, but not down there.
Not down there. No, we're not going down there. Not down there. Not there.
Oh, darn.
Well, you know, not now. Just kidding. But see, men think that, you know, people think that we just want to do what they want us
of
to
course.
Do because they were born and they are so lovely. And we should be happy to be in their presence.
Absolutely.
So, no, it's not the case.
No, no.
Do I have lipstick on my teeth?
You do, but it's there.
Does it add to the pink?
That's good. There it goes.
Do I look pinky?
Speaking of man, we are doing a song for you called "The Amazing Man" today.
Ooh, yummy! We're gonna hear it.
So there
yes.
You go.
Are you gonna do that? Are you gonna do that live?
Yes, I guess. Because we have the beautiful.
I'm sorry. Wait. Whoa. Where's the girls' manners? Okay, ladies in the house. There's two males, and they exist. I have to remember that they exist too. I'd like to introduce. Lakotah's lovely lover.
Heidi,
Frankie,
darling.
Frankie and his bass player. He's just going to be stringing her
Frankie
right along.
DeVille is an amazing artist. And this song
and a producer.
Features Frank DeVille on the guitar acoustically, ladies and gentlemen.
And let me tell you something. He was here last week, if you saw the show, with American Idol Clint June Gamboa. And he's... you guys are playing Saturday night together, which, by the way, we're going to tell everyone about.
Yay!
He was here last week. Frank was playing with him, you know, in the background, and he was so humble that he just sat there against the wall and just, you know, moved when he had to play, and then he didn't even, like a little mouse, he didn't peep unless I talked.
Well, Frank is a superstar.
He's a superstar.
He's incognito.
He is incognito.
He's a superstar.
Can we say who you've written for, or what you've, or can we say anything?
Absolutely.
Okay, because I don't know but you have written for some major, I mean, the biggest singers in the world.
Yes.
So, you know, can you do your brag list for me so I can feel good?
Well, I worked under a producer named Walter Millsap for Timberland for a few years. So we wrote for every single major artist that they were writing for to fulfill their publishing obligation. So the first record that I was on was the Timberland Shock Value record, and that was back in 2004, and that sold 6 million copies.
Wow.
And then after that, I had a couple Grammy nominations with a gospel artist named Trinity 5-7. We won Song of the Year.
Really? I love them.
So cool. Yes, we won Song of the Year for that song, Listen, the GMA Dove Awards. I don't know. You might not know. It's a kind of a pop song.
No, I do know it. It's great.
Yeah, a pop song. But
wow.
Kelly Rowland wrote for Usher.
Beyonce?
Yes, Beyonce.
I had to say, because it's like, how could you forget the Beyonce?
Could you?
Right?
Well, you know what? There was, people think, what was it like working with this artist? Uh-huh. And I worked with my partner, Lamar Van Sciver, a very talented engineer and producer, and we worked in a room this size over a garage on an old G4 Mac that was struggling, and we were making hits. We just kept, you know, we had some great opportunities, and we just kept writing, and some things really hit. So,
did you actually take the recording off of the Mac that was having problems? Is that what you said? Is that how you?
We had, yes. Later we did update, but it was amazing what we were able to do with what we had.
I was going to say, Apple. I can see what you're saying, because you'd be surprised what you can do on a Mac. And I was like thinking, well, if he didn't have a Mac, say he had a PC, or whatever.
Well, this was a G4 Mac, so this was a couple years ago. So at that time, it was like, oh, you're working on a G4 Mac? You know, that's what's wrong with you?
Yeah, right.
But we were making it happen.
Wow.
And so, excuse me, I wrote, for even some harder acts like Onyx.
I love Onyx.
Yeah. I played some guitar and wrote for some stuff for him. Yeah, a lot of hip hop. And then...
Have you done any other hard rock, like Slipknot or...
No, mostly pop and R&B.
Because you look like a rocker, but, he's got soul. And guess what I got to tell you about guys with longer hair? Ladies, you'll want to listen up, and so will you men, because that's, if you have, anything from the, ear down, kind of like cool rocker guy hair or cool surfer hair or a ponytail, even a braid, you could have half. I don't know what a half and half is, but if you have longer hair as a guy, generally, the guy's more sensitive, and he's a good lover, and he's loyal. It's the longer hair guys that you can actually trust more than the shorter hair guys. you know? And I, because they have to hide behind something else. But it's because you're not afraid of, you know, letting it all hang out.
That's right. I dealt with a lot of stuff, too. I mean, my hair has always been kind of, you know, I'm Scottish, and we have kind of bushy hair. And
the Scottish area.
You have the
I
ringlets
didn't know
in your
that.
Hair.
Yes.
If you just let your hair air dry and you put the stuff, it'll do these. I love that. Yeah. The ringlet things.
It's a lot to keep up.
Oh, I know. Yeah. You don't want to get dreadlocks or knots. You have to brush your hair every day.
Actually, there's some secrets that I do to keep my hair kind of like this. I get a lot of compliments on it.
Oh, that's but great. But anyway, we love your hair. But I'd like to hear you guys sing more. And you know, I mean, not more than your hair, Frank.
More than your hair.
Yeah, right. I almost love you more than my hair. Just kidding. Do you think my hair is pretty?
Yes.
But super pretty.
I'm super excited to hear you sing live. Her voice, you will melt.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Well, maybe not the guys. They won't melt. They'll go the other way. And that's not frozen.
Oh, my goodness. Whew, she's fast and quick.
Yes.
I can run real fast around the block. Oh, did I pour you the white, the Pinot?
The Pinot, sweetie.
The wine.
The Pinot.
The white wine.
Okay. I'm good.
So we're going to have wine and listen to a live performance because she's amazing.
Oh.
Her name is Lakotah.
The song is called The Amazing Man. And it's on the new album that was just released called The Maker.
Yesterday it was released.
Yeah.
This is the acoustic version. Transported through time, we were lost, engulfed in notions of desire. The point had come. Complete surrender of all I ever knew to be let go of your identity. Love resounds, shining out to me. But don't be fooled by things you see. Give to yourself. Give to me, amazing man, the amazing man, the amazing man. You see, Venus is my ally and Beast is my friend. Young prince is playing beauty just pretends. Come into my life. Don't give yourself away, you'll get lost in me. Your life force is what you receive. You are thus giving yourself to thee. But don't be fooled by things you see. Give to yourself, give to me. One thing that I
Good job.
That was amazing.
Thank you so much. That's the first time we've played the songs unplugged.
Really?
This is electronic alt rock song. So
well, I really have to tell you.
It's crazy.
I really have to tell you guys. I think you should also release this acoustic version that you just did right here.
You know, as we were just talking about that.
It was perfect. It was perfect. You're live. You're amazing. And your eyes. I love your character. And
you're so sweet.
Lakotah.
Stop it.
You know what's so funny? I was thinking, some people could say, Lakotah. It's like, who am I licking?
You can go the way and go, Lakotah. How you doing?
No, you're doing, you know? Lakotah.
There you go. Right. That's the one.
Where is that from, that name?
Lakotah is my mother, in her travels, was adopted in the Sioux Nation, and she named all her daughters American Indian names.
Oh.
So I was actually named at Pine Ridge when I was 3 in a ceremony of the Lakotah people. And I do recall being very small and looking up and all the tall Indian chiefs, and the chief said, put his hand over my head, and he said, this child is named after the Lakotah Nation.
Ooh.
And then there was a big powwow dance, and I fell asleep. My dad put me in the back of the car. I remember that. And that is my real birth name. That's why it's kind of important to say it correctly.
Say it, that's why I was asking about it.
You know, in this country, the lazy American tongue, you know, hides so much.
Would you show men how to use their tongue when they pronounce your name?
Well, that has
the
been
Pino,
done,
by the
yes.
way. I accidentally gave you Merlot.
Oh. And this, ladies and gentlemen, in the studio with us is
Frank.
And our amazing alchemist and the CEO and A&R of Boo Boo Records, the Doctor.
Yes. Well, come on, gentlemen. Come on the camera. You
here
have to
she
come
is.
Over here.
Come say hi.
Come over to my camera.
Without all you things would not be possible, darling. Right. This one here.
Wait, come over to
this
my camera.
This is Dr. Linda. She's the alchemist.
Did you want some more
and
wine?
And she needs some Pinot as
Wait,
well.
We didn't give her some more wine.
There you go. There's hers.
Yes, yes. Toast.
To a wonderful song.
Please.
So, thank you. That was awesome.
Yes.
Very well done.
Yes, it's Lakotah, awesome. And then we have, you know, her lover, Frank.
Yeah.
And then, give me your name and your website.
Linda Iniguez.
Is it L-I-N-D-A?
Yes.
And
Linda.
L-Y-N-I-G-U-E-Z.
With a D, not
okay,
a T.
Whoa, that was super confusing. So just spell it, because apparently I'm a male right now and I can't think when there's a woman in my breast.
No,
I mean,
it happens to us all, sweetie.
That was funny because I didn't
glasses.
Mean that.
So I can see you better now.
Oh, wow.
She's the mastermind behind a lot of the programming on stage.
Great.
And, of course, the CEO of Boo Boo Records, and she's an alchemist upon the stage. This is true. She does magic.
I do sound magic.
You do sound
magic.
So you're the sound engineer.
I do all of these things.
Oh, my God.
Yes, I do all of these.
I think it's so hot when women do stuff like we do. You want to know why? Because I took off my own closet doors by myself, and from that point forward, I felt...
You did? Oh, right.
You
by
felt
myself.
Empowered, wow. didn't you?
I felt so...
A kindred spirit.
I had my drill, right?
A kindred spirit.
The electric,
spirit.
And I'm like, yes. Who needs a guy? Yes. I can do this. And I was like, you go, sister. It's like, she gets it.
Oh,
and I'm like,
it.
Yes. Her house is amazing.
Right?
Remodeled it.
Yeah,
her, yeah.
It's great.
It's beautiful.
Oh, totally.
You have to totally come over and check mine out.
Oh, I do. Then you have to come over to my house and check mine out.
I will.
And then we can share secrets.
Yes. I did something so cool. I'll have to show you what I did. I turned my closet.
I'm so excited right now.
Super excited.
This is so fantastic. So you're a businesswoman and you know talent and you are a talent yourself.
Talent right there.
Hello.
Hello.
I mean,
I've
you
always
know,
believed
I've
in
almost
that
said, I bet, you know, people just come up to her stage,
just
you know,
a spoonful
men,
of
women,
sugar.
Dogs and anything. And they're like her voice.
Animals
they're
come
like,
out of nowhere.
They start crawling on the floor.
The medicine go
that
down.
Well, that wasn't the sexy voice you
no,
just did.
No.
But yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. God, I thought it was. I'm so sure.
Okay, back to
hello.
Here
like,
we
don't
go.
You know, sexy.
We're exchanging this, okay.
Hello.
Oh, I'm so sure.
So look what I did, you guys. I turned my closet. Okay, I
Why
I
is
actually,
your screen all cracked?
I just dropped my brand new iPhone 6 last week.
Oh, my God.
Oh my God. I know. It's really, you guys have to pay the deductible. But anyway, I'm really bummed out. I just did it to my iPhone 5. I don't know what I'm trying to
what
show
you. What are
you
doing? Were you trying to show me your house?
I don't know. It's in my photo somewhere. Anyway, should we sing another song? Because
We do have the video.
Okay.
Yes.
If you want to play that, then we'll sing the song acoustically.
So there's the handyman.
After we see your house, of course.
I turned the closet into a makeup room.
Now that's intelligence,
that's
sweetie.
Idea.
Now that's something
Dr.
L would do.
Can you see?
That's an idea.
Wow.
That's my handyman. I'll just flip it.
You guys look
off.
Great on camera together. Sure. Look at you two. Look so cute.
Oh, that's the thing that I'm
hanging.
Great. Oh, really?
Kindred spirit, kindred spirit.
What have we started over here?
All right, that's enough.
Okay, that's enough.
We're being stupid. So let's get back to the men. Because apparently I wasn't, stupid enough.
Oh, thank you, doctor.
I almost wore that color today, too.
Did you?
And I wore this because I was going to put that over this.
Chartreuse.
And then I said, screw it. It looks so okay, because it's covered.
Yes.
I have three bras on, so
do you?
Nobody can see
They're
through.
Fabulous, darling. Fabulous.
Yeah, I don't like see-through things.
I see two, but I don't see three.
I see three.
Right? And then it's see-through here. So
oh,
this
wow.
Is
look at that.
This is
look at that, you guys.
A 90. The things you can do. This is a 90.
Well, because you have a perfect body, so just sit out,
oh,
man.
Oh, you are
just
so sweet.
There.
Hey, you got the perfect breast, voice, eyes, and lips.
Breast,
and
eyes,
and you know what? If I were a man, I would love a woman that had a little push. And let me tell you something, okay? Because there's nothing. I like bones when you're trying to grab something. And
you know,
it's quick and fast, right? But then there's the cushion. And I'm telling you, that's a lot more comfortable to lay on when you're tired. And it's a good reason to cuddle. You know, no, it really is. You know, like that's why babies love to lay on their mom's laps.
That's true.
Because, right? We like carry the weight after baby. Yes, exactly. Yes. You know, and men... And, adult males still try to do that.
We're doing kindred again.
Well, like I always say, it's better to be looked over than overlooked.
Do you do voiceovers?
No. Well, no.
Because you talk like
in my own head.
Wow.
Yeah.
Do you do that when you're around random people that you don't know?
Yeah.
Does it scare them away?
Does it kind of?
Yeah, you're not on.
I don't know. I'm not aware of it, but...
Yeah, really?
I really don't know.
She just didn't take her meds today.
Oh.
She's
bipolar. I did. I took them. All four of them.
But Lakotah is insanely talented. So while we're, gossiping, should we play the music video or do you guys want to do another one live?
Oh, we'll do... The second song I'm going to do is the music video, which is the new EDM pop dance top 40 AC single entitled... I Feel Your Body.
And this was released yesterday.
Yes, and you're going to hear a lot of it this fall. And we are performing in acoustic, but on Saturday we'll be performing at full-on band, EDM, woo-hoo, at the Avalon. So here's the video. It's on YouTube, and you can get it at lakotahmusic.com.
Spell your name, I'll just do it for you.
Take another sip, sweetie. Okay. It's Lakotah.
Thank you. I was wanting more wine.
So, we're going to see the video and hear it. I'm not sure if we're seeing it or hearing it. What are we doing?
Well, it depends what, our engineer wants. We're seeing the whole video.
Ooh, cool. It's kind of sexy. So.
Okay, you could have the cameras on us, but we might get sexy too. Go ahead and play it, Mr. Engineer.
the house beat.
Heidi in the house. Heidi's in the house.
You got it going on, girl. Hi.
So there it is. That's our new single, and it's you'll hear it all over.
I bet you're a tigress in bed.
Well,
darn.
Like they say in my country.
Did you get the body you liked? Because you know the song is called "I Liked."
I did. So I'm very happy about that.
Ooh, yummy.
Yeah.
Ooh, tell a little bit about the body.
About the body. Yeah. About the body.
Yes. But don't talk like that when you do
sorry.
Do the sexy voice. Do the normal voice.
I went godly there for a moment. And my children. No. No, it's it originally started the song called "I've Got Your Party Right Here."
Ooh, but did you write that?
I wrote the song in like 5 minutes. It was one of those, you just write, boom, it's done.
And the party meant down there in their package?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, well, now she's shy and she's got to go into character.
I'm so embarrassed now.
Now you do that. You know what? You do that when you get shy or nervous because you're actually very into it. You're very introverted.
So shy right now? Thank God.
Okay, but like, don't talk like that for like a long time because we want the normal voice. Okay.
Sorry.
So see, no, really, because you have a very pretty voice, and you have a very great personality.
Oh, because she's got personality.
Ooh, can you do that for my show open?
I can.
And
I
saying
can.
She's got personality, so people know I have one.
Anyway, because we wouldn't have known.
You would have had no idea otherwise. So listen.
Okay.
So you got the body, and then it was
just
you really wanted somebody's body.
Well, you know when you
and
feel
you were
it,
feeling
it's abstract.
It, and you can do it in five minutes.
Because you know when you feel me. Yes, when just you feel, because when you feel that vibration with somebody, it is inevitable. It's you will join together. It's a feeling. Everything is feeling.
It's a magnetic feeling.
Absolutely. So as opposed to, I want your body or I need your body, I feel your body.
What? See, I think she's...
I was just hypnotizing Heidi there.
Yeah. I was like, wow, I was swinging on a chandelier for a moment. I really went to the chandelier swinging.
Did
you? For literally like a two-second thing. My mind is very active, you know.
Indeed.
I don't know where I go sometimes, but it's fun in my head. Inside Heidi's head. Wow.
That'd be a great show.
That's what the name
inside
of...
Inside Heidi.
That was the name of a it actually is the name of one of my shows. But I can't say.
Okay.
But in my head, it's fun. So anyway, back to you.
Okay.
As a singer, did you, when you realized you can sing at a young age, and this is always a very curious point I love to point out with people, because some people don't know, you know, their mother, you know, could have told them like me that I was nasally, and therefore I don't think I could ever sing. But there's times when I catch myself singing. But, you know, it's just because she was just really hard on me.
Oh,
stop with the sob
Sorry,
story,
sweetie.
Heidi. Just get over it. Okay, anyway, back to you. So, you know, it's just, no, I'm serious. But so, you know, did you know at a young age? And then were you pretty sure that that was the path you were going to take?
Well, I did know at a young age because I just knew I would be little, and I would be little. Now I was little, sitting in a car, and I'd hear a song on the radio and go, "God, I could write that."
Oh, really?
You know, like, oh, they should have done this instead of that.
Really? Do you know what song that was?
No,
for sure?
I don't. But me, I remember
you just got
that.
It.
I'd be go. Oh. My mother would play Black Sabbath throughout the house. My father would play Johnny Cash, and I grew up in hearing like all this really good music. So, started playing an instrument at like, I don't know, 6, 7, 8, I don't remember, guitar, and then took a trumpet through school and played piano. I taught myself piano, and I played the bass and drum set. I really good at a drum set. That's my favorite thing to do is play the drums.
That's the sexy. I think that looks
so
great.
Hot when you're just slamming on a pocket.
It does, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you ever want a chick to think you're hot, just grab 2 sticks and a bucket and start banging.
Go.
That's all you need to do.
If you only knew, darling.
2 sticks and a basket and you're ready to go. Right? Sorry, I'm a dork, I know.
So, anyhow.
Now, is this when you were, you know, singing alongside of the native, you know, tribe that you're
from? Well, I actually never sang with them, and I'm not from the tribe. I was, my mother's adopted in them, Heidi, and we
I
have
know,
Indian
but it sounded,
name. It does sound good, doesn't it?
No, it sounded funny when I said that, when you were in the Native American tribe, you know.
So now I went to, I didn't plan. I always knew I was supposed to be a singer and a writer. But, you know, I went to school, college, and majored in other things. But I kept knowing. So I finally and put out a demo a while back and just moved on from there. And on this particular album, I'm playing all the parts except the lead guitar, cello, and no, I guess I'm playing everything else but that.
Yeah, so you can do every instrument, not just with your vocal quality.
I can.
But with your, you know.
The musician. I'm a pretty good
musician.
Your
nose with the accents and all, and also the fingers that you use on your strings.
Yes.
You can do that at all. She's
my strings. You have no idea, Heidi.
You know, she strums her strings really well.
I do. So it's really awesome when I read it. Meet incredible artists like Frank DeVille here, who can really play the guitar.
Oh, Frank.
You know what
is,
I mean?
Right.
That's a whole other level.
So can we see Frank and, you know, before we have Lakotah sing again with you, can we just see you, you know, just kind of strumming your strings as you do normally when you're lounging around the house? No, just, you know, I want to, and, you know, think, maybe play something for me. Like when you think of a Heidi song. And so then she could start singing Out of the Friend Zone with Heidi Selexa. It's a, you know, the men need to learn or whatever.
Well, we're going to sing for you our hit song here, I Feel Your Body.
Yes, but can we hear Frank just riff it? Just watch it.
Riff it, baby.
Woo! Ooh!
How you doing?
I know what's going on down there.
So good. That's so good. Yeah.
All right, Frank. It's terrific. And it just comes natural for him. You know, he didn't have this planned.
No.
It was how he felt when he, you know, thought of me and the show. And it was a little all over the place. But a little together. And it was fun. And I wanted to hear more and I wanted to see where it was going.
Yeah, you know. You just pull it, you know, off the cuff.
Yeah. You know? It's like men on a first date. As long as they are showered beforehand and brush their teeth. Always be clean. The ABCs, ABC, always be clean. Always be confident.
Always.
You know, and I don't know, you know, if it, you know, you like men, because sometimes, you know, women don't.
Ah,
and, you know.
Really?
But,
Oh, that's right. I have heard of that.
And no. I'm just saying, you know, some women can be just as mean as men are because they don't really like them. You know, they just think they need them.
Ah.
You know, and in some cases they do, but not at all. Really just kind of talking myself in a hole here. Lord Jesus, would you help me get out of the hole that I dug myself in? I can't get out of my own hole.
Oh, yeah. Woo! That was wrong.
You were not in your own way. You were in your
own hole.
Right?
Oh,
okay? Can't get out my own hole.
Because you can't get out of your own hole.
Baby, that's better why. Climb out that hole.
I told her she shouldn't have
telling you right now, girl. Playing climb out the hole.
She really climbing out the hole.
Look, the engineer's laughing. He's laughing. We've got him. We've got him.
Jarvis. Yeah, nobody Jarvis can see laughing. Him, so it looks like we're like looking off into space. Like we're talking to ourselves. Jarvis is not a real person. No, he is. He's on to the left of me. My arm's this
he's
way.
He's laughing, so there you go.
He only laughs when I'm funny. One time I'll keep, you know, I the other night I kept him on till 1 a.m. and then he fell asleep. I said, I was only funny for 2 hours.
That was it.
He was done. So can we hear you do another live?
Indeed.
Yummy. Give me another yummy. And, you know, by the way, on guitar, acoustic guitar, and, you know, Lakotah can play that herself too because she knows
how to string. Not as well, of course.
Not as well as Frank. But Frank is a very well-known writer and producer and musician. Frank DeVille, otherwise known as the lover of Lakotah.
Yes, that's exactly true.
To her right.
This is the single you just heard, the EDM Top 40.
Yeah, that just got released yesterday.
That just got released. And our first time doing it acoustically, and it's a whole nother animal.
Yummy.
Dancing around from one to the other, your moves are working so right. I can tell how you crave a new kind of lover. I come to you on the floor, your eyes get caught in the light, the heat runs deep to the core. So don't you put up a fight. I feel your body, I feel your body. I feel your body, I feel your body, I feel your body. Our bodies coming in close, 'cause I feel the heartbeat up to the music. All your sexy just flows, keep melting me down. A kiss with a kick, no need to search anymore. I'll set your desire free. I take you off the dance floor, and now you're coming with me. I feel your body, I feel your body. I'll give your body a smile. Feel your body, feel your body. I'll give your body, I feel your body. I feel it so. I feel your body, I feel your body, and don't you know? Hey, I said, I feel. I want you to believe in me. I want to say. Set you free. I want to set you free. I'll give your body a smile. I'll give your body a smile. I want your body.
I want your body. I want your body. I feel 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 your body, I feel your body. I'll give your body a smile.
Wow, that was sexy. I mean, that was hot.
He's clapping, he's clapping, he's clapping.
We don't have... We don't have air conditioner here.
Clearly not.
But no, you do. Really steamed up the room. So if we start going smoky here.
That was so awesome to do. Thank you so much. This is just wonderful.
No. I have to tell you that. Yeah, you like really...
rocked.
I didn't freeze, but I didn't melt. I went the other... I like melted upward. I'm not even a man, but as a man, I could just feel it. Like I was in, you know, Montana in a forest in the middle of a meadow, naked, looking up at the stars with the perfect guy, and there
that's
were only
so
deers there.
Awesome.
Right? In the middle
awesome.
Of a meadow.
Yeah.
That's like really
the I love when the album the songs invoke different things to all of us differently.
Yeah, that was hot.
That's what it's about, and it's all sexual, but spiritual too.
Well, and that's when you relax and let go.
Yeah.
You know, let go. Mm-hmm. Stop being such control freaks. Mm-hmm. And let go and just be okay with yourself, being vulnerable and not vulnerable and happy and not happy, you know. Cool, not cool, just all the different colors of all of us. If you just really embrace it, you know, you learn to appreciate your own rainbow.
Oh my goodness, and ladies and gentlemen, wow.
Yeah.
Amazing. Yeah, words of wisdom. Yeah. Truly, though.
That was great.
But, you know, that's how I think, and I don't always say it, but that's, you know, that brought colors. I mean, I felt everything in your voice. I saw it's colors I never saw before, like, you know, how they describe heaven. Ah. You are given a gift. As I don't see, you know, gold, all these different and all these different colors that I've never seen that I can't even explain. But these stars of gold, it was like I saw a music video there, and I had the whole thing created in my head. So I should be able to, you know, produce it and
make
it.
Well, you're hired, sweetie.
Thank
so
you. But I saw it
next week, 6 a.m.
Yeah.
Right. Studio 3A. Okay.
Oh, dear goodness. Can it be 6:30? That's how you know she's a flake.
Yeah, that's right.
She stays up till 5 every morning. But you were fantastic. Give me all of your website and social media. I mean, I have it, but for the listeners.
Right.
And talk normal.
Okay.
Because the men are still in the rainbow land after that.
Hello, boys and girls.
You know, you could sing your, why don't you do this?
Sing?
Say, I want your body, or I feel your body, and then do your website.
Hmm.
Or do it in the that tone.
Hmm, no. No.
Oh, that sounded pornish. I'm sorry.
It was. Hello.
Hey, well, what is Lakotah?
Well, my website is.
Oh, yeah, let me
come
tell
call
you.
Me at my website, lakotahmusic.com. Late at night, when you need some good music and some really hot press pictures and a very sexy music video.
To no, your left, you will find.
That was my porn commercial.
That was really hot.
Okay.
But that was sexy. I mean, that was sexy. You know, you could imagine her in lingerie as she's on top of the bed. Okay. I'm
that
just
was
saying.
Dumb porn sexy.
I know.
Sexier.
Give me, and then also, yes. You know, you can sing Thank You for Listening and Watching Out of the Friend Zone with Heidi Selexa.
Thank you.
Because I want you to sing
for
some stuff from
Listening and Watching Out of the Friend Zone with Heidi, 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 my friend. referencing Sinatra. I don't know.
That was really hot. I love it. Thank
but
you.
Lakotahmusic.com. Okay. Go there. Join my mailing list.
Yes.
Watch the video. Buy my new album. It's called The Maker.
Mm. And it just came out.
It did. So,
and you got like 300 million hits on SoundCloud.
300 million point 14.7, darling.
Oh my gosh.
No, not almost. Almost.
On SoundCloud.
It's getting
on
there.
SoundCloud.
SoundCloud, we have my song Heaven's Own. And that has like 95K hits and streams, and it's really awesome. It's not a single as of yet, but of course on iTunes it's available.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So you can purchase that as well.
Yes.
And we do it on my website. It's on the SoundCloud. You can also hear it right there. So
Lakotah, you are amazing. You are hot. You are talented. Oh. Lakotahmusic.com. Yes. I believe I said that.
Follow
right.
me on Twitter at Lakotahmusic and on Instagram at Lakotahmusic and like me on Facebook at Lakotah.
You know, guys, you could get a wide variety of different women in that one. I just give you a few colors, okay? She's like, rainbow. I'm Heidi Selexa. Thank you so much for watching.
I love you.
And
thanks, everybody.
Out in the Friend Zone. And Saturday night here in LA, I will be introducing her on stage. Woo-hoo! Along with American Idol, who was here last week, Clint June, and a bunch of other fantastic artists at the Avalon here in LA.
That's right. The Rooftop, baby.
Yeah.
10:30.
Woo! Rooftop. Yeah. Woo-hoo! Bring it on, girl. It's a rooftop party.
Dr. In the hell.
Yeah!
Come on, girl, get up. Get up a boom, drop the boom.
Baby got back.
You dropped the bomb on me. Oh, baby. You dropped the bomb on me.
She a brick house.
My trail. This back in the day, I was playing with Frank. We was rapping on the mic just another day on the Heidi Show. Nothing really had to say. I went gangster on her. What could I do? Cause I'm kind of like a rapping fool. Oh. Thank you.
Was that my part?
Yes, that was your part, sweetie.
I didn't know. I didn't know what I was really going to go for. It. I would have. I was there, but I didn't know I was supposed to. Let's do it one more time. Take it from the top.
Oh. All right. Boom. Come on. We're going to get it right on the store. Because like when I was just a little girl, I learned how to sing. I learned to rap. I learned how to be. But now I'm inside the studio on Sunset Boulevard in Hollywood. And I'm gluing down my feet. I know what to do. I know how to sleep. But I'm starstruck because I got set right here next to Heidi. Go.
Hi, Grandfather. How are you?
Yeah.
So when I was a little girl, I used to climb on this mountain with my grandpa, and I'd be like, hi, Grandpa, and I'd be like, hi, Granddaughter, and there were like these goats. They were called Billies or something, or was that my neighbor's name? I don't know who the other blonde guy was, but I think he was my neighbor. We used to kiss. Anyway, it was a Saturday night, and I said, hi, Granddaddy.
Well, hello, honey. How are you?
Grandpa, I have to tell you something.
Yes, sweetie?
Well, the other day, I climbed up on top of the hill.
You didn't.
I did, and I know it wasn't supposed to, Grandpa. It was okay, because it was in the day.
Oh, honey.
But there was a Billy on the rooftop.
Billy?
It Billy? Was a Billy?
That damn Billy?
Billy, I love
I tell you, one
Grandpa,
of these days, I'm going to just get Billy, and I'm going to teach him a lesson is what I'm going to do.
But, Grandpa, I have to tell you, I love Billy. I love him.
Girl, you get into this house right now, young lady.
I love my billy goat. What am I going to do without my billy goat?
It's a billy goat. Well, then that's great, honey. It's a billy goat. No, yay.
Grandpa.
Yay. We're back on the farm and we love our billy goats.
Well, he's a man. It's just a goat man. It's his last name. His name is Billy and then goat.
Thank you very much.
Seacrest out.
Oh, we'll bring that Seacrest back in.
That's fine, young Metro man.
I like Ryan. He gives me the giggles. I know. He gives me the giggles. Does he give you the giggles?
He does. You know, he introduced me once a while ago at the Key Room, and I had a different band.
Yummy.
He introduced my band.
Oh, yummy.
I don't think he remembers.
Did you want to see him naked?
Well, actually,
that's
I did.
That's another show.
Yes, that is.
We have to go.
Oh, no.
Because Ryan's not been down there. Bye. I'm Heidi Selexa, and thank you for watching and listening Out of the Friend Zone. Saturday night. You
gotta see
Lakotah. You're listening to Out of the Friend Zone with Heidi Selexa.